Hey everybody, this is TCG Productions here, and if you're wondering what the noise is in the background, that's actually going to be the subject of this quick little video. So this is the, this is going to be, well, this is the prelude to a much bigger video. And what you're seeing here is what used to be my spare main computer system, the spare gaming rig. It hasn't been like the direct subject of, I don't believe, any videos, but it has definitely been a key system in several other videos, including both of the file server fiasco videos. Now, this system is almost a carbon clone of my main computer from about mid-2015 with a few upgrades, such as an Intel Pentium G3258 processor, an ATI Radeon HD 5850 graphics card, and even a 1TB Western Digital Blue hard drive. This system is about to go off to a friend, to Gavin actually, and I figured I'd make one last video of the setup here before it goes away permanently. So what we have here is a very noisy power supply fan, because I'm running this, well, let's put it this way. I'm running Prime 95 on a maximum heat torture mode, and Furmark on the graphics card, and I've got multiple system monitoring utilities such as Open Hardware Monitor and GPU-Z, watching the sensors. Just maintain, and I also have a custom fan curve set with MSI Afterburner. GPU is running about 75, 77 degrees C. GPU loaded, of course, maxed. Not using a whole lot of VRAM. Pushing anywhere between 45 and 50 amps through the GPU core, and the VRM phases are running at about 70 degrees C. CPU temperature is 63 C, and I'm using about 2 gigs of system memory. Now, if you're curious, this is most certainly Windows 10 Pro. So, let me see here. This PC properties. So as you can see, Gavin Gaming Rig, 8 gigs of RAM, device ID, product ID, system type, Windows 10 Pro, 21H2, and system is fully up to date as far as I'm aware. Yeah, it's not patched Tuesday yet. Patch Tuesday will be on April 12th. But yeah, it runs pretty snappy for Windows 10 Pro on a spinning hard drive, because if we go to control panel and we'll keep that on outdoor. Yeah, if we go to control panel, system and security, create and format hard disk partitions, it opens up the disk management thing, and disk 0, 931.51 gigabytes, and properties. Okay, I actually need to go into device manager. So I'll go into administrative tools, computer management, and then I don't want performance, I do want device manager, however. I'm going to go disk drives, WDC, WD10EZEX. So there we go. That is the model of the hard disk. Device is working properly, of course, and smart stats are healthy. And that just reminded me, I need to install, we have an SM bus controller and some kind of an unknown device. Let's just search Windows. Yeah, that's helpful. Not. I wonder if this is a USB 3 XHCI drivers. Yeah, anyways. I made one last video of what's going on here before the system goes away forever. So anyways, So anyway, this is a video. Yeah, here's MSI Aftermarket 4.6.4 hardware monitor. And yeah, I've got a custom fan curve going on here. Go ahead and view that. And I actually need to open that right back up. The GPU is about to start baking if I don't reopen that. Of course, I have it configured to start up with Windows. So, yeah, I don't like the stock fan curve that graphics card has. So, guess what? I use MSI Afterburner instead of custom one. And, of course, everything else is the same. You got a billion and one card reader, USB 2, of course, basic computer case, and you got Asus Asus DVD reader and writer, so... And, of course, here's Prime 95 running. And this has been running for about 30 hours now, so... Anyways... Let me go ahead and shut down Prime 95. Yeah, 29 hours, 29 minutes. So, go ahead and shut down Prime 95... And temperature 4 and temperature 5. I don't know what those are, but I'm willing to bet... Temperature 4 and temperature 5. I don't know what those are, but I'm willing to bet that those are CPU VRM temperatures. Now I'm going to go ahead and terminate... Furmark. And everything is starting to fall down now. So, anyways... Yeah, this is TCG Productions. Oh, wait, I already have Disk Checkup installed. Yeah, I've already done that. That's why there's a Disk Checkup icon down here in the system tray. And, of course, I've also run O&O Shutup 10 against the system and turned off all the Windows spine crap and whatnot. Yeah, the system's much quieter now. O&O Shutup 10++ is what it's been renamed to. Yeah, I got all this stuff disabled. So, anyways. Prime 95 icon still resident in the system tray. But anyways, and if you couldn't tell, I've customized user profile just a little bit. But anyways, this is TCG Productions here. Peace out, guys. Peace out, and see you in the next one.